Again, which is it?
If you could just talk a little bit about the Fried Utley Foundation and the award.
The very beginning.
Yes.
What we did at the beginning.
Yeah.
The Fried Utley Foundation is set up in honor of really my mother and father. My father was arrested in the Soviet purges in 1936. I went to Russia with a translator and got the documents, and he was actually executed for being one of three leaders of a hunger strike in a Soviet concentration camp. In the American, we came to give this prize in America. Obviously, it's not, prison is not like the Soviets, but there are certain disturbing developments here, particularly the violation of the Fourth Amendment. The Fourth Amendment means a judge must give a writ of there has to be grounds. They have to have a warrant in order to arrest people who go in their homes. And Pat Nolan is doing this great work in reforming America's system.
This award and this panel tonight is a very personal thing for you from your family's experience and knowing Pat and all he's doing here in the United States to kind of reform the prison system.
Well, precisely, America, we're a long way from Soviet system. But their movements, when the fear of drugs and terrorism is giving tremendous powers to the police, to imprison people, to threaten people with long sentences, to get convictions. Many innocent people we know confess to crime they didn't commit because of the system, the way the system works. And it's very much for us who came from a refugee, I was from the Soviet communism. America is so wonderful, and it's our Bill of Rights. And we who know the outside world perhaps more see these threats as, my God, what are they doing here? It's not going to lead to what I escaped from. But I think those of us from foreign countries are very conscious of the Bill of Rights and what it means to be an American.
And also, have you been impressed with the groundswell of support amongst the conservative movement? You know, people like Mr. Richard Viguerie and Grover Norquist, who've come to really support Mr. Nolan's cause.
Yeah, absolutely, and David Keene. And many other top conservative leaders have now signed on to this. They have the... I'm not affiliated with that group, but... It's something whose time has come. It's become a respectable issue for conservatives, and very much of concern to all of us. That in fighting terrorism and drugs and whatnot, we don't lose our most basic freedoms. And then the economic consequences to the United States is billions and tens of billions of dollars, locking people up for these interminable sentences, or putting them right back in prison for a minor parole violation. This is ruining, certainly the state and municipal finances. And the damage, I would add, the damage to young people caught up in this, because they can't get jobs later when they're released. It's the ruins hundreds of thousands of lives.
Thank you very much, Mr. Utley.
Yeah.